Hello, hello everyone. I hope you're having a great week. Well, we are approaching the final week leading up to Christmas. Probably the office and the work parties are all finished, and now you are moving on to the family parties. Generally on Christmas Eve and Christmas Day, that is when we get together with our loved ones, or maybe not so loved ones. For a lot of people, the family Christmas parties are a joyous occasion. We look forward to them. We don't get to see each other a lot throughout the year, and we just cannot wait to get together and celebrate. I know for myself and my family, that is how we are. We are blessed to be able to feel that way about getting together with our loved ones. Unfortunately, however, not everybody feels the same way that we do. There is a lot of animosity that goes beyond family members. There's a lot of pulling and tugging that goes on. I've had a lot of you reach out to me over the past couple years while I've been very active on Snapchat and share some of the difficulties that you have with your family members and ask me for what my thoughts are, which I think is wonderful. I definitely do have distinct thoughts on a lot of these things. I can't necessarily say that everybody is going to really want to hear what I have to say, but I think sometimes we need to hear from somebody else who is a non-biased person that really doesn't know the dynamics of the family, does not know what is going on in the family, and does not know about any of the struggles that you're dealing with. I decided what to do today is I printed off a recent question that I had received from somebody on Snapchat, screenshotted it, sent it to myself, printed it out. I am going to read this question, and I'm sure some of you can relate because I do feel like the power struggles tend to be among in-laws. This is not always, but a lot of times this is the case. So I am going to read this question that I received, then I'm going to hit on my thoughts on this question and kind of take it into the whole spectrum of getting together with our family and my thoughts, how to deal with it, what to do, how to react, and anything else that comes to my mind that could be beneficial to you. Of course, always remember, this is only one person's opinion. Here is the question. How would you handle a situation where your sister-in-law has manipulated your mother-in-law against you, all because they don't respect boundaries? I have two small children and I want nothing to do with my mother-in-law or my sister-in-law and have them nowhere near my children. My sister-in-law is a textbook psychopath. She is married with one child of her own. My husband is coming around to seeing my view, but at the same time, he sympathizes with his mom. He says she just wants to see all her grandchildren together. I will not let them walk all over me. I tried to sit down with my sister-in-law last week after not seeing her for 3 years. She was making all sorts of things up and caused a scene in public. I have never met a woman in my 37 years of existence that runs to their mommy to fight their battles. I am being bullied by them. I just want to focus on my babies. Also, my sister-in-law is 4 years older. Sorry for this rant. I just don't know what to do. Well, not everybody is going to like what I have to say to this, because initially when I read this, the first thing I thought was, this is a sister-in-law and a sister-in-law that are both nothing more than drama. I know that doesn't come off nice, but reading this, that is what I see. I don't read this and think the mom or the sister-in-law are completely at fault. I always believe there's three sides to every story: his, hers, and the truth. So again, I'm a non-biased person looking in. To me, there is a lot of unnecessary drama going on in this family, and it is so unfortunate and it is so common for people to do this. My question is, why? What are you gaining from this? Where are you getting your kids? Your kids are watching all of this. First of all, one of the things that I want to say is, let's always remember that not everybody is going to like us. And that is okay, because frankly, you and I probably don't like everyone. I think it's very important to be respectful to people at all times. I don't believe that you have to tolerate inappropriate behavior coming from somebody, but I definitely would have to say that you have to be okay in accepting of the fact that everybody is just not gonna like you. You don't necessarily, this person that wrote this letter, you don't necessarily really have to like your sister-in-law, and it's unfortunate, and you really don't have to like your mother-in-law, which I think is unfortunate as well. But I think the fact of the matter is, the childish behavior that is going on here needs to stop. And you can't control what other people do. So you can't control what the mother-in-law is doing. You can't control what the sister-in-law is doing. But you can control what you are doing. So be the bigger person and control it. Be nice, be kind, be respectful, and whatever you do, never include your children. That grandmother should be able to have a relationship with those grandchildren, even if you don't. Same with the sister-in-law. I think it is so unfortunate how children get drug into these messes. And you know who really ends up suffering in the end? Is the kids. And the thing that I have noticed by just people that I know is that a lot of families that have drama, if you were to ask family members if maybe their parents, you know, did your mom go for periods of time without talking to a sister-in-law or a sister or a mom? And they will be like, yes. What happens is the seed is planted and it just trickles down. It's like a snowball that keeps rolling and building on upon itself. You have to be the one to stop that pattern, because your kids are watching, and if they're seeing that you're doing this and having this behavior and these type of relationship issues, chances are they are going to as well. There is nothing that would kill me more than my girls ever being in a situation in their adult life where they were not speaking with one another. I would give up my own relationship for that not to happen. That would kill me. That is so important. But if I were showing that and that's all they were learning growing up, what do you think would happen? I think it's pretty clear. Let's go back to what I initially said about people liking you and you not liking people. You know, I know there's people out there that probably don't like me. It's inevitable. Now it's really gonna happen because I'm on YouTube. We all know that you either like a YouTuber or you don't. But you know what? I don't necessarily care for everyone as well. But again, it goes back to I'm just respectful. There is also a little thing that I have taught myself over the years, and boy, has it been a wake-up call for me. There are definitely people in our lives, especially family members, and I don't just mean extended family. This could be people that you live with as well. It could be your spouse, it could be your children. What I have learned to do is, instead of getting so uptight or irritated by certain things that my loved ones or people I may work with or friends or anything like that, instead of getting, you know, irritated with them by a bad habit they may have or a way that they treat me, I have learned to find the good. Believe it or not, there's good to bad. I have trained myself to find the good in what they are doing. So if, let's say for instance, I have a family member that just constantly interrupts people, just nobody can get a word in edgewise, they're always interrupting. I tell you what, that drives me crazy. That just drives me crazy. Generally, I tell myself it's unfortunate the parents never really trained and taught that child. It's so disrespectful. And I cannot tell you how many times I just want to say, would you shut up and listen? Would you let this other person talk? But you know what? I'm not going to change that person, am I? So it really is wasteful energy for me to try to fix it, because I have to fix myself. But what I do is I let that person be my teacher. And what they're teaching me is that I won't do that. So when you reverse how you view the things that people do, it really is a wake-up call, because you no longer see the negative in everything they do, you see the positive, because they're teaching you, Tracy, Don't interrupt people when they're talking. It's disrespectful. You don't like when you see other people do it. Make sure you're not doing it to others yourself. And that really is the key, is learning to not so much focus on the things that we want to change about other people because we don't agree with it. We don't like the way they're treating us. We don't like how they're leaving us out or they're leaving one of our kids out, but all the other kids are invited. It's so easy to get caught up into that. But there's your reminder. They're gonna do it, but I'm not going to do it. So let it be your teaching moment, and it really will make you look at the situation different. A lot of times what happens is it just becomes this power struggle. You get mad at something that they did, so in a way you want to get them back. So really, they're baiting you. They're taking bait, they're throwing it out there, and they're reeling it in nice and slow, and you're just grabbing onto the bait. Well, don't be the person that grabs onto the bait. Be bigger than that. But being bigger than that also means that you just shut your mouth and you just be respectful, because that's really being the bigger person. A lot of times people think they're being the bigger person, but if they're involved in it, you're not being big at all. You're actually being very small, just like that person is. The other thing is, if you are constantly thinking about the issue, if you are constantly talking about the issues that you have with a family member or your in-laws or something like that, then basically you're becoming a slave to it. You are imprisoned by this. So you may be thinking that when you're getting back at them, ooh, I'm one up on you, ooh, let me at you, all this stuff, and you get that little fuel in your fire, but really, you're just a slave to the situation and you're imprisoned by the person. You have to learn to let things go. You have to let it go. You have to drop it. You have to move on, because who wants their life to be full of this? We don't get a second chance. We have one life. One life with these people that maybe sometimes may drive us crazy, but we have one life with them. It's okay. Everybody's gonna be fine. You're gonna be fine, and so are they. So let it go and move on. Another real key thing to remember in all situations, and sometimes you even have to think about this with your loved ones, your own children, you have to think about it with your spouse. We can't change people. All right, and I think that's what we spend so much time trying to do, is change others. Well, if they would do this, or if only they would do that, or this and that and this and that. But you know what? Nobody is going to change for you. Nobody changes unless they want to change. It doesn't matter what the issue is. The only person that can be changed is you, and it can only be done by you, nobody else. So focus more on yourself. Be a role model for your children. Let them view you, take a situation, and handle it in a very classy way. That is a real teacher right there. But if they see you acting up, talking about people, then who really is the teacher? Not you. You're the small person. One of the biggest times that you see a lot of these issues too is in a divorce situation. You know, let me just share a little story with you. My parents divorced after 19 years of marriage. My sister was 18 and I was 16. To this day, we have no idea what the problem was. It takes two. They probably were both at fault in some way, but it was never our business and they never made it our business. There was never any bad talk amongst either of them. Neither of our parents ever came to my sister or I and talked about the other person. That was such a great gift. There was never any fighting. There was never any pulling this way, pulling that way. They were always respectful. And I think that is so wonderful. And you just don't see that. But you have to ask yourself, what am I teaching my kids if I'm doing this, if I'm having these power struggles? And I'm going to tell you right now, ladies, it comes more from the women than the men. I haven't been through a divorce except for my parents, and that one was just clearly something different than what you normally see. But I know a lot of different people that have been through divorces, and what I see clear across the board is women just, they're out of control, and your kids are watching it. And you think you might be fooling them by bashing their dad to them, but they're listening and watching. Eventually, they're going to catch on and they're going to go, no, Mom, you were the problem. If there's a divorce situation, keep that divorce and how you feel about your ex to yourself, because a father is a father and a husband is a husband. They are completely two different roles. So to talk bad about your spouse, and I'm not saying that men don't do it to women. Please don't comment below and tell me any differently. I don't care. It is clear across the board, but I think I see it more with women. And also, women really utilize this or divorce people during the holidays. Stop it. You're hurting your children. This power struggle is childish. It's immature. And you're only hurting your children. You know, grandparents want to see their grandkids, whether it's his, whether it's your ex or your husband, whatever. And they have that right. You shouldn't play the game. And a lot of times it boils down to one big thing, and that's called control. It really isn't the fact that you necessarily want your kids to be with you. You just want that little bit of control. And women are very good at it. They're very manipulative a lot of times. Now, I hope I don't offend anybody by saying this. Remember, I'm the non-biased person here. You know, maybe today you need to be the one that hears that. Maybe today you need to step back and go, yeah, you know, I do kind of do that. Nobody has to know. You're watching me and nobody knows. And the other thing is, don't sit back here and go, oh, so-and-so should be watching this video. Because there's a reason you're watching it and so-and-so might not be. Take what I'm saying and see if you can pick up anything that can help you. Certainly, I've never been through a divorce, so I can only speak from what I've been through with my parents and what a gift it was. I'm hosting a party in a couple days. My dad and his wife will be here, and my mom will be here. She lost her husband a few years back, but the four of them have came to every one of our family functions together. They've all been there. We've never had to have separate parties, and I wouldn't do it. You come. If you're invited, you come. And we're one big family. You know, keep your battles to yourself if there is any. Thankfully, there really isn't, because they've moved on. They held their head high. They dealt with it in a mature manner. And they always cared about their kids. Those of you that are doing all the drama and stuff like that, you're being very selfish. You really are. You're not putting your kids first. And it's very unfortunate. And they're the ones that are going to be hurt in the end. The last thing that I want to comment on with this particular subject is what I call the pulling back and forth. And again, it kind of goes back to a control thing. So you've got a married couple. Husband has his side of the family. Wife has her side of the family. Husband and wife have kids. Where are you going to spend what with? You know, we can't get to everything and we can't make everybody happy. And then if you have a divorce thrown in there, there could be three separate homes that you have to visit during the holidays. You aren't going to please everybody and quit trying. But if you are the grandparents, my advice is that you don't put an enormous amount of pressure on your children. An example would be my husband and I, we have five children. My in-laws do not put pressure on us that we have to be here, we have to be here at this time. It has to be all done their way, and my family doesn't either. We know when the parties are, we know where they're located. We do what works for us. We have older children now that some of them have boyfriends' homes that they're going to go to as well. Some of them may have to work. That is life. That is how it is. Let your family members know when the party is. Ask them if they will politely let you know if they can be there so you can plan for seating and food. And if they can't, it's okay. Don't make anybody feel bad. You know, we miss the whole reason of the season. Everybody wants to make the holidays about them, but it's not even about us. It's about a baby, for crying out loud. Let's not miss this, people. Let's not miss this. We should be spreading joy. We should be spreading love and smiling and happy. Nobody should be fighting. This is when you set everything aside and you celebrate. You celebrate the gift. It's so important. It's really important. It really is. Believe me, I'm passionate about this. I'm passionate about family staying together. I really am. And I hope that you can have a heavy heart on this topic if it's something that you're dealing with. All right, enough. enough. We've got parties to attend and people to see and loved ones to love on and gifts to share. So on that note, again, I hope you have a Merry Christmas. You know, be the big person this year and step out there and smile and show some love. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you haven't. Give me a like if you like this video. Any suggestions or comments are always welcome. You know that I love to interact with all of you. And on that note, I will see you in the next video. Thank you so much for watching.